today, I'm gonna show you women how the man is supposed to cook for y'all. It can be in bed, wherever, but as long as they're cooking for y'all in general. Now, I wanna show them the 1, 2, 3 step of the reason why I do it, how I do it, and the way I do it. Now, it's gonna be some time for them to get it, especially for the ones who don't know how to cook. Y'all gotta remember that. But for the one y'all slacking, women beat y'all with grilling and all type of stuff. We're supposed to be winning in that. Y'all trick. But for the ones who know how to cook, well, let's get into this. Let me show you guys the right way to do it. Let's go. When you're cooking the eggs, you gotta make sure that you've been very delicate with them, because especially when it comes down to the stove, because when they're on the stove, they cook mighty fast. You gotta really watch it. As for the butter can really burn just as fast. I'm gonna show you the next step. Now, when you're putting the eggs on here, make it a little hollow bit. When you're putting eggs on here, you just pour it just a little bit. Just like this, simply pour it a little bit. So you're gonna do this. You're gonna stir it. And you wanna make sure you stir it, and like I stir it in circular motions. That's just to get a little, you know, get the scrambledness in there, because I like omelets just as well, but I prefer to scramble it. You gotta make sure you're doing this right, because if the room like scrambled eggs, you gotta make some eggs scramble. The whole cooking process. You gotta make sure you're getting that good, real good. Now when you think it's done and it looks pretty good to you, and that's when we take them out. That's how I do it. Pour a little puff bowl, put it in the safe for later. Side. On with the next. Next step is I want to get your links. Get your links. Now, I put them inside. Turn it on about, I'll say I'll put it on about 350. Put it on about 350. You slide it in there. Real nice. Close it and wait to be cooked. Next step you want to do is, while it's waiting and it's cooking inside the oven, make sure you wash out your pot. If it's all clean and that look like this, you can almost see your reflection, then that's when you clean. Because some people don't know the difference between clean dishes and dirty dishes, they just don't know. So while that's getting ready to cook, just leave that just right there and you go to the next. Next thing you do is, you want to get some bread. Now, some people toast it, but I like it buttered, and I don't use too much butter, but just a tad bit of butter. You know what I'm saying? So I use these white bread, put it on here, and I like to toast it. This look is not like crisp, but not too much, just like crisp. So, get my knife. Now, I'm going to get my. Last one. Cup a little bit. Then you want to turn it to about 5 again. About 5 again. And that should do it. And then about 5 again. Yeah, don't turn it too high. You know, make sure you don't turn it too high. That's high. It really, it's stuff start to burn. So then make sure you do that. Well, you don't have to, but I like to, like I said, I like to get in circle motions with the butter. You know what I'm saying? That way it burns faster for me, and it's like, you know, it slides off and everything like that. Now, what I'm gonna do is take your bread, place this bread right on it. Make sure you get it. I'd like this. I don't know about you guys, but I'd like this. I put the bread on top of the butter and I smear it in circular motion again. So to get the butter can get inside the bread while it cooks. You feel me? You get what I'm saying? That cook for a little bit. It's gonna get a little toasty and a bit more butter, and then I'm gonna flip it. And next, when you start to see it looks a little like this, like this one's a burn on my edges, then you can go ahead and flip it. Now, the butter don't necessarily have to be on there, but you can put it on there while the bread's on there at the same time. I'll show you how you do that. You get the butter, get a little bit. Here. You want to smear like this, smear it. That's gonna come on the same way. You gotta make sure you do it the right way though. And y'all, when y'all cook it like this, and y'all bring it to her and she wake up, she like, it smells so good. So good. She gonna give you that, ooh, it's almost done. She gonna give you that nice, nice. Y'all know what I'm talking about. It's making me hungry. So I'm cooking a little faster the second time because that means that I or the stove, whatever you guys call it, gets getting hot. So when it starts to look like this, it's done. Well, some people like it more toasted, but it don't have to be like really crunchy, but just lightly crisp. So, go ahead, let's stir that circle of motions. Put the bread. Now it's look nice and brown like this. It's ready. Not every time it's gonna come out the same color. Not every time it's gonna be browner than the other. As long as you know that it's lightly crisp. Sometimes it burns much faster than last time. That's something you gotta remember. So I'm gonna put that to the side. I'm gonna turn the eye off. Check on my sausages. It's almost done. Almost ready. I'll be back. I think it's done.
Hot air.
Make sure you use mittens because you don't want yourself to get burnt. Now some people tend to leave it just like this, but me, not me. I use more seasoning, more stuff, you feel me? More stuff. What we'll do is, you gotta know if I put that jump back on, turn that fire all the way up. All the way up. And you can't use butter, but sausages already have grease, so you don't have to use butter. Some people do that, but I like to, you know, I like to get more seasoning. I want like more flavor. You feel me? I like it more. I don't know about y'all, but I like my sausages pop, hot dogs pop, ribs, I like everything burnt pop, whatever you want to call it. That's how I like it. You feel me? Just a little bit of onion powder. Just a little bit. I don't want to say too much. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Stir it again. You want another one? Oh, hold on. Okay, delicate. You flip your wrist like this. It'll look like this. When they get a little bit darker, that's when you know that they're good. That's when you know that they're good. Now this whole operation take about 30 minutes, maybe less, depending on if you know what you're doing. But I like to take my time with it, you know what I'm saying? So that way, they can taste, they can feel that I put my heart into it every time I cook. That's how a lot of people looking at me, oh, bro, you cook, man, this stuff's good. It ain't kind of happen that one time slacking. Not on me, bro, not on my name. Not me. It's my baby. Enjoy this, because you would have a soothing, cool night. You understand? You can be a morning no matter what time it is. Oh, you cooking for her, and you sure that you love her through food? So it's a little bit, you know, because it's getting a little dark like that. Get a little boink. I ain't say burnt. Boink. About done. Go ahead and pour it up in there. Then you're done. When it looks like this, let's go get them. Woo! No time. Thank you for watching. For y'all who don't know about me, my name is Paula D. My Instagram is official_paula_d. Whoever new to my channel, like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification at the top, smack that bell. I want you to bust it. Don't smack it. Bust that bell. Make sure you get a notification every time I come around. Y'all be safe. And cook for your girl. You feel me? Cook for your girl. They need it in their life. You feel me? But part of the game, we out of this bitch, y'all.
I pray on my thumb, but I can't start on two. I've been doing shows in the past, now I'm doing shows in the pit. Get straight to the pain without a delay. Take a little boy, I'm too hard. Hopped on the beat, it's too